I got money that you don't know about. Hit the scene and get showing out. Rock designer you never heard of. Cold-blooded murder. Kush got me heavy eye.
Hey, what's up, guys? I'm back with a couple of reviews and also a topic that I wanted to discuss. So let's jump right into it. The first pickup is something that I missed in the beginning of the year, and I've been looking for a decent price on these. I actually managed to get them through the GOAT app, if any of you are familiar with it. If not, I definitely suggest checking it out and maybe downloading the app. So the way it works is, once you purchase the shoe that you like, the seller has to ship it to the GOAT location, which I believe is in California. And there, a specialist has to verify your shoe and authenticate it, and then it gets shipped out to you. Unfortunately, my shoe got delayed. It took almost 3 weeks to get here because the seller was on vacation. I actually purchased them on Thanksgiving Day, and I think it took them a little over a week and a half to ship them out. But either way, I got them in now, so let's go over it. So this came in a regular ASICS box, size 12, no special packaging. But thanks to GOAT, they did throw in a few little extras. So the first thing is, you have this card that kind of authenticates the shoe, and it does say the name of the person that, you know, looked over the shoe and authenticated it. So, which is a nice touch, you know. Second is a shoehorn. They actually put in a shoehorn for these, which is pretty nice. Just has the GOAT logo on there. All right, and this shoe comes with three sets of laces. You have the, I want to say it's like a dark beige, an off-white, and the laces that I threw in there. But if you haven't guessed by now, this is the Packer ASICS 25th anniversary, and this is the Dirty Buck. Really happy with the shoe. I feel like the quality on these is on point. Nothing too crazy. The upper is mainly a nubuck material, but it's a nice soft nubuck. I believe there's, you know, you have a couple of different nubucks. You have like a durabuck and a nubuck. This is one of the softer nubucks that I felt, so I'm pretty happy with the upper. You also have a premium suede on the tongue and the inner liner. On the outside, you have this off-white color, and on the inside, it's like a dark tan leather. Also, you have a leather Packer logo sewn in on the tongue here. These are the laces that I decided to go with. It's kind of like a wax rope lace. I just think they look better in the Gel Light 3. I like rope laces in the Gel Light 3 myself personally, but you know, it's up to you. Go with whichever one you like. I did wear these today, so they are a little scuffed, but you know, I'll get them cleaned up later on. The midsole is this, it's not a pink, I want to say it's like a ham color, if that makes sense. It's kind of like a dark pink, and the upper portion of it, the plastic heel counter here, is like that tan material again. Really nice shoe, really clean look. Really happy with the pickup. I'm sure you guys have already seen reviews. Oh yeah, on this side you have the Packer logo embossed, so you know, nothing too crazy, but like I said, great quality and a really good shoe in my opinion. Alright, so the second one I picked up today, shout out to my connect that hooked me up. These come out on Friday, and I highly recommend getting these. You know, really dope shoe in my opinion. I really love this silhouette. I did like the colorway, and it is something new. So this is the HypeBeast Ultra Boost. As you can see, the box is just a regular Ultra Boost box. These did retail for $180, so like I said, they come out on Friday. I know a couple of places are doing raffles, so I'd definitely suggest entering a raffle or just check with your local retailer to see, you know, what their system is going to be. Alright, so the shoe, obviously, you guys have seen pictures. The midsole is a white Ultra Boost. The upper is this prime knit material. It's a mixture of black and gray. I'll give you guys a closer look at the design here. One thing that is different about this shoe, as most of you have noticed, there is no cage system, hence the name Uncaged Ultra Boost. Really comfortable, great design. One cool thing that I just realized by reading the tag is they have some type of chip in the tongue right here behind the Adidas logo. So it's called an NFC microchip, which you can kind of think you connect it to your phone or whatever. If there's, I believe there's like an Adidas app or something, and if I'm not mistaken, it kind of keeps track of, you know, all of your activities and all that stuff, maybe running distance, whatever that is. So yeah, it's a pretty cool touch. So you have a chip in the Adidas logo there. I did try them on. They do run true to size, so I would say stick with your regular size. If you have a narrow foot, maybe go down a half a size. Like I said, really comfortable shoe, great materials. The insole is actually a leather insole that they use on a lot of the Consortium Ultra Boosts. And down there you have HypeBeast and Ultra Boost again. Under the insole, as you can see, it, again, they're using that boost system, which is pretty nice. And you do have the torsion system in the outsole as well. One thing that I did recognize on this shoe that I didn't see on a lot of Ultra Boost this year, so this is something I know that they're bringing to the 2016 Ultra Boost. You have Continental right here on the outsole. I believe this is from Continental Tires, and they are making the tread on the outsole a little bit more durable. I've heard a couple of people mention that the outsole wears out pretty easily if you're actually using these for running. So I guess they're improving the outsole and using this Continental tread, which is a nice touch. I know all of the 2016 Ultra Boosts are gonna have it, so I guess they're bringing it out early with this model. Like I said, it's a really nice touch. It's a super comfortable shoe. If you've never tried an Ultra Boost or even an NMD, something like that, I highly recommend it. The technology is phenomenal. By far, you know, the most comfortable midsoles definitely come from Adidas. I'm really starting to get into a lot of the minimalist, you know, the NMDs, the Ultra Boost, all of that stuff. So you'll definitely see a lot more videos of, you know, stuff like this coming from me. I just love the way they feel and the way they look. So yeah, those are the two pickups for today. Finally, the last thing is a topic. I actually had one of you guys ask a question. I believe it was on my Concepts New Balance M80 video. If you guys are familiar with the shoe, it is kind of like an all suede upper with long hair suede. Somebody asked me how I clean that shoe, so I thought this would be a good time to kind of discuss what my, you know, what my method is for cleaning and all of that. And I'll try to make it quick, maybe try to help some of you guys out that, you know, have questions about how to clean an all suede shoe and stuff like that. Alright, so for cleaning, you could basically use, you know, dish soap, anything like that. You know, anything that doesn't have a lot of chemicals really works, that won't kind of damage the upper. But it's a little different, you know, cleaning leather from cleaning a nubuck or a suede, especially if it's like a pigskin suede, because you have to be very, very careful with it. So like I said, you know, dish soap, anything like that works. Personally, I like to use Jason Mark. It is a little pricier. I believe it's like $20 for the whole package with the brush. But if you can afford $200 on shoes every week, you can definitely afford to get a good cleaner. Just kind of a warning, and I'm sure most of you already know this, I do not use this stuff to clean any type of suede, anything like that. I only use this on leather and midsoles. So what I usually do is I just get a little container, fill it up with warm water, and use a brush and put a little bit of this stuff on. I'll kind of go over that really quick. So if you buy the whole kit with the bottle, it comes with this hard bristle brush. I never really like to use this because I feel like it's a little too rough and it damages the paint. And like I said, God forbid you use it on suede or anything like that, it's just going to really damage it. I actually bought the other brush that they sell, which is a premium cleaning brush. The bristles on it are a little bit softer. I'll give you a look at the packaging here. Jason Mark premium brush. The bristles are a lot softer, and I just, you know, I usually get one of these every 2-3 months or something like that, and I'll try to switch them up because after a while these do start to fall out. So yeah, this is definitely the brush to use. So I'll fill this up with a little bit of water, kind of dab it in there a little bit, and I'll like to rinse it off. So I like to get about 90 to 95% of the water off the brush. I don't like it too wet because if it's too wet, it's going to leak all over the shoe. It's going to get too foamy. And if you are cleaning a suede shoe, if it gets on the suede, like I said, it does damage it. So I'll, you know, rinse it off completely until there's no water dripping off and it's just a little bit moist. That's about it. about 5-6 drops of this. You really only need a little bit. If you get too much foam, like I said, it's just gonna get everywhere, so it's not a really good idea to use too much of this stuff. So the first thing I'll do is I'll clean the midsole and the outsole, basically just going over it with the brush, a little bit of back and forth, get all the scuffs off, just try to be very careful. So this is the tricky part, because when you're cleaning the midsole, you want to avoid touching any of the nubuck or the suede. So you have to be very careful when you're cleaning it. If I am getting a little bit on there, it's not a big deal, I'll be able to wipe it off later, but you want to avoid as best you can getting the foam or the water on the nubuck or the suede. So I'll go over the entire midsole, the outsole, whatever, just clean it all off. Then I'll just rinse it off under the sink. And again, very, very carefully, not getting any water or foam on the upper. I just basically kind of brush the foam off and just rinse it under the sink and get all of the water and foam off. I'll usually dry it off. I use paper towels, but you can also get this microfiber towel from Jason Mark. I'll give you guys a look at it. It is reusable, so it's a nice touch. I don't use it too often. I just use bouncy or whatever, a regular paper towel. Just a kind of a warning, never use paper towels that have any type of print on them, any type of ink. I've made that mistake. Even though it seems like the designs don't come off the paper towel, they actually do if you're using it on a shoe. And if you get any of that ink on the shoe, it's impossible to get off. So always use plain white paper towels if you are using them. So after I dry that off, this is what I use to clean the suede and the upper of the shoe, if it is suede or nubuck. You can basically get these anywhere. This one I bought from Foot Locker. It's mint brand, and it is a suede or nubuck cleaner. You can get these pretty much anywhere. CVS, any shoe store sells them. And this is absolutely the best thing to clean suede or nubuck. So I'll give you guys a look at it. It's kind of like a sponge material almost, and it does come with this eraser. So usually what I'll do is I'll go over the entire upper and I'll brush in one direction. If you do a lot of back and forth brushing, it will damage the suede or nubuck. So just try to be careful and brush it in one direction. What it's actually doing is it's raising the suede and the or nubuck a little bit. So the dirt kind of comes out as you're raising it. When you brush it in the other direction, it'll kind of get the dirt out. So maybe about, you know, 5 to 10 brushes in one direction and then a few in the other direction. That's the best way to clean. Now if your shoe has a scuff in it, that's a little more trickier and you have to be careful. This eraser is really good for, you know, pretty deep scuffs, but you don't want to brush too hard. So for example, if I do have a scuff somewhere on the upper, what I'll usually do is I'll lightly brush the scuff with the eraser, just a little bit of back and forth. Not too deep and not too hard. The problem is that if you do it too much, you're going to damage the suede again, and you're going to have a bigger mark there than the actual scuff, and that has happened to me before. So I'll usually be very, very careful and just do it a little bit to get the scuff out. But again, this is the best thing to use. Just kind of go back and forth. You might have to do it for a little while. It is a little tedious, but, you know, like I said, if you're spending money on shoes and you really love your shoes, you're going to take a little bit of time to clean it. That's basically it. You know, those are my suggestions. If you guys have any questions, need any tips, please hit me up, let me know. You know, if you guys have any suggestions for me that work better for you, you know, let me know. I'll be happy to hear them and maybe use some of that. All right, guys, please like, comment, and subscribe. Stay tuned for more videos. Peace. Kush got me heavy eye. Shoes cost me 35. Doors all suicide. Cold-blooded murder. Just got a check, I be so dead fresh, I confess. Cold-blooded murder. And a nigga just got a check, I be so dead fresh, I confess. Cold-blooded murder. Fucking women that's in your dreams. My reality ain't a dream. Pull up on them and make a scene. Now the Lord is self-esteem. I'm in a black Benz coupe with a bad bitch too. Smoking cabbage, ooh, S-class, fuck school. I've been out past two, rolling on about two. Styrofoam getting screwed, VVS is on the juice. That's a cold-blooded murder. My attorney gon' have to turn up. Marty Ellis on the feet, Ben Shife on the beat, Python on the seats, and swords on the beat. Chew that young nigga, shredded like a motherfucker. All that niggas catch a wave, now it's our summer. Oops, oops, got rid of the roof. In a world full of lies, still speaking the truth. Cause hey, I got money that you don't know about. Hit the scene and then get showing out. Rock designer you never heard of.
cold-blooded murder. Kush got me heavy eye. Shoes cost me 35. Doors all suicide. Cold-blooded murder. Go. Only play with my son, only play with my daughter. Only mention my name and you know get money to motto. I want them bench friends, the big bills. I know that foreign appeals to women and heels. They want that moolah, moolah, we got it. Pull up, step out, I'm fly, united. Hold steady, everything, cope steady, please. Give me a good side, paparazzi, got a fetish. Staying fresh in my genetics. Ooh, call the paramedics, too pathetic. I said it, my success got them jealous. But I got money that you don't know about. Hit the scene and get showing out. Rock designer you never heard of. Cold-blooded murder. Kush got me heavy eye. Shoes cost me 35. Doors all suicide. Cold-blooded murder.
Just got a check, I be so dead fresh, I confess.
Cold-blooded murder.
And a nigga just got a check, I be so dead fresh, I confess.
Cold-blooded murder. You can take a nigga out the ghetto, but you can't take the ghetto out of me. You can take